welcome back to my channel. My name is Shelby and today I'm going to be doing my March stats and standouts. This is where I talk about all of the reading statistics I had from the month of March, all the books that I read, their star ratings, and five of my favorite books from that month. As always, I will link all the books I talk about down below and let's get right into it. In the month of March, I read a total of 14 books and that totaled out to 4,957 pages. I read 10 romances, 3 thrillers, and 1 historical fiction. So I'm really happy that I bumped up my thrillers for the month of March. For star ratings, I had no 1 and 2 star ratings. I had 4 3 star ratings, 5 4 star ratings, and 5 5 star ratings. That is a little bit skewed because that doesn't include half stars, so I either had to round them up or down. I read 2 library books, 1 book off my shelves, 2 ebooks, and 9 ARCs. So I'm quickly going to go over all 14 books that I read and their star ratings. I'm not going to go into details about the books. I do have 2 wrap-ups from the month of March where I talk in depth about these books, so I'll link those down below if you want to hear my full thoughts. You Are Not Alone by Greer Hendricks and Sarah Pekkanen, I gave this 4.5 stars. Undercover Bromance by Lissa K. Adams, I gave this 3 stars. Stay by Serena Bowen and Elle Kennedy, I gave this 4.5 stars. Fresh Meat by Jasmine Miller, I gave this 4 stars. The Trade by Megan Quinn, I gave this 5 stars. Beautifully Broken Life by Catherine Cowles, I gave this 4 stars. Old Fashioned by Candy Steiner, I gave this 4.5 stars. Little Secrets by Jennifer Hillier, I gave this 5 stars. Dear Enemy by Kristen Callahan, I gave this 3.5 stars. Mine Till Midnight by Lisa Claypaz, I gave this 2.5 stars. Mum's the Word by Stacey Hart, I gave this 3.5 stars. What Lies Between Us by John Mars, I gave this 5 stars. Truths I Never Told You by Kelly Rimmer, I gave this 5 stars. Watch Over Me by Mila Gray, I gave this 3 stars. Okay, let's get into all of my standouts for the month of March. I'm going in the order from when I read them, so it's not by genre and it's not by which one I liked the most. The first one is You Are Not Alone by Greer Hendricks and Sarah Pekkanen. This was their latest release. I've read both of their previous releases that they co-wrote together and I absolutely loved them, so I had a feeling I would love this one too. This is a psychological thriller about a woman named Shay, and she witnesses a woman commit suicide in the subway, and she ends up feeling really connected to this woman because she kind of looks similar to her. So she tracks down where her funeral is and she attends the memorial, and that is where she meets the victim Amanda's friends. And she meets the Moore sisters named Cassandra and Jane, and they seem like the perfect friends and they quickly take her under their wing, but they start molding Shay into kind of a mini Amanda and it is very weird. We're jumping perspectives between the Moore sisters and Shay and you can definitely see that they have sinister motives, and we're kind of just waiting for Shay to catch up and see what is really happening right in front of her. And this one was really, really good. It had a lot of twists and turns and I love how quickly that it read. And if you liked their previous books, I would definitely recommend you guys pick this one up. The next one is The Trade by Megan Quinn, and this is the 4th book in the Brentwood baseball series. And this one follows a pro baseball player named Corey Potter. We were introduced to him earlier in the series because he is one of the heroine's older brothers. And he is traded mid-season to a new team that he is not really a fan of. And he ends up attending an event for one of his teammates' charities, and that's where he meets one of his teammates' sisters named Natalie. And Natalie is recently divorced and she works for this charity. The two of them are attracted to each other, but it is definitely forbidden because she's the sister of one of his teammates. But by some chance, they end up going on the same vacation together because they have a lot of mutual friends. And they end up having to share this romantic room on this romantic vacation. So it is a room sharing type of situation and things get really steamy when they are in the tropics. And then their relationship kind of blooms when they come back home. And this one I loved so much. I really, really liked Corey. I thought that the 3rd book's hero was my favorite, but I don't know. I really liked Corey and he might be my new favorite. My heart definitely went out to him because his trade was very, very hard for him. And his new team and all of the fans did not accept him at all. And I also felt for Natalie because she is recently divorced and she had a very hard marriage. And so I just loved seeing them get together. And if you really love sports romances, I think you would love this one. Then I have Little Secrets by Jennifer Hillier. And this is about Marin and Derek, who are a married couple and they have a 4-year-old son. But 1 year ago, he went missing in a shopping center around Christmas. And it's been over a year since he went missing and he has not been found or anything like that. And Marin had hired a PI to try and track down her son, but instead the PI discovered that her husband was actually having an affair. And so it's kind of a revenge plot because she decides she wants to seek revenge on the woman he's having an affair with. So it kind of has 2 different plot lines. It's about this missing little boy, but also about this secret affair. And this was so, so good. It is everything that The Arrangement by Robin Harding wasn't. I was so enthralled by this and I was addicted to it and I couldn't put it down. It was so wild, and I don't want to say too much else about the book. I think you should go in blind, but if you love thrillers, you would love this one. The next one is What Lies Between Us by John Mars, and this is his latest release. It doesn't come out until the middle of May, and usually he writes sci-fi thrillers, but this one is more of a psychological domestic thriller. It is about a toxic mother and daughter relationship between Maggie, who's the mother, and her daughter Nina. And we find out in the beginning of the book that Maggie is being held captive in her home by her daughter Nina. We follow both of their perspectives, past and present, and kind of see the events that led up to them being in this situation. And your mind jumps back and forth trying to decide who is the good guy and who is the bad guy. I loved how many twists and turns were thrown into this book, and my mind could not make up who the good guy and the bad guy was. They are both super messed up, and I just loved this story so much. And definitely check this one out when it comes out in May. The last one is Truths I Never Told You by Kelly Rimmer, and this is kind of a cross between historical fiction and women's fiction. We're following two different women in two different decades. We're following Beth in 1996, as well as her mother through journal entries in the 1950s. Basically, Beth and her three siblings have to put their father in a nursing home because he is at the end of his life, and Beth is a new mother and the only one who isn't really working at the time, so she decides to go through the father's home, and she enters this locked attic, and she discovers all these journal entries from her mother, and she starts reading them and learning about her mother who died when she was really young. And we are seeing those journal entries, and Beth realizes she's actually really similar to her mother, and we're learning about her mother through these journal entries, and her life was really sad, and I felt so bad for her mother because she lived in the 1950s. Postpartum depression wasn't really known about, and she was really struggling, and a lot of women's health services were illegal and not available to women, such as abortion. And so this is a very hard and heavy read, but it is very, very good. So I definitely recommend it if you can handle the subject matter. So those are all my stats and standouts for the month of March. I'd love to hear if you've read any of these books and if you liked them. As always, I will link them all down below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys all in my next one. Bye.